Hello again, this is Everett Johnston, and I'm putting out another video. This one's about after you become a journeyman and even a master plumber. This is about more knowledge that you're going to need to learn and more things you're going to need to study. If you want to work for the government, you're not only going to want to be a plumber, you're going to want to learn pipe fitting. And believe me or not, this is the simple stuff. You've already learned all about gas, you've learned about solar, you learn about so much more. So these are the other types of stuff you need to know. Okay, the uniform plumbing code. Now every 3 or 4 years, they give you a new plumbing code. So there is a 1997, here is a 1997, but this is the uniform plumbing code also, okay? Then you have the international plumbing code. Those come out ever so often too. So international plumbing code, you have your state and local plumbing codes. Now, which one do you use? Well, bottom line, if you're working in your state, you want to work with your national plumbing code. And normally now, I think many states, it's the uniform plumbing code. So whichever one, your inspector, whichever one you guys use mainly, that's the one you want to use. So you'll learn code. You can't even pass the journeyman test unless you learn the code. And then as the master code, you'll need to learn all that also. And then to go further, you're going to need effective steam traps. What are steam traps? How are they used? How does it work? Temperatures. So learning about steam traps. You need to learn all about steam traps. You can take classes on this. You can go down to your local community center and take classes as a journeyman. Hopefully your company will pay for it. There's more a steam utilization course, which I've taken, and it just helps you understand, you know, all the different types of steam, you know, elimination of steam leaks, learning how to work with boilers and out of the boilers, what type of traps would you use. There's all kinds of steam that you'll need to understand, which is basically getting hospitals and dairy farms and just all kinds of stuff for steam. There's more design of fluid systems. So you design the fluid systems. You understand what it's about, how these systems interact with steam and what they're about. Let's see, what else do we have? More steam traps. This is a leadership tour course that I took. Steam, steam, steam. You need to understand steam. You don't have to be a pipe fitter. You don't have to weld all the steam, you know, the steam pipes. If you work maintenance, you just have to understand steam and how it works. There's a design of fluid systems also, another book. So there's just continuing books in this stuff. There's another steam utilization, designing fluid systems. So just another course, another class, but it's all about steam. And there's more steam conservation guidelines for condensate drainage. Where do you send that condensate? You know, send it back to the boiler. Does it go? Does it get dumped into the storm drain? Whatever. And you need to learn solar systems. Yes, solar systems. Plumbers do many solar systems that are for the home, and large solar systems that are due for commercial builds and stuff. Pipe fitters would do them in the real world, like Local 208. I belong to Local 3, or I did. Now, you know, I'm retired. So, but there you go. So you got solar systems. Learn solar. Then you learn all, you need to learn all you can about these drains. When you're installing drains and carriers and stuff, you can go to Zurn and these other places and get these. You can figure out how deep they need to be, what type of stuff you get. But these are all materials that you'll use as a plumber pipe fitter. Purification and treatment of domestic water supplies. How do you do that? What do you do? You know, do you put chlorine? How much chlorine do you put in the water? This tells you about how many and how much chlorine. Normally when we're putting new pipes in, we put one tablet for every 10 foot. So if we're running a sewer line, we're running 100 feet, we're putting in a tablet for every 10 feet. So that's 10 tablets I forgot already what I just said. Water hammer arresters, okay? You need to know all the different types of water hammer arresters. The specifications in most drawings will tell you what type to use. But by understanding these, you'll understand the book and you'll understand what those hammers and how long they last and when should you replace them. Do you have valves in front of them? Don't you have valves in front of them? And that's why my book will explain about valves before hammer arresters, before mixing valves, all kinds of ways to help your building run more efficient. And then not last but not least, you really need, any day now, they're doing a lot more solvent systems. I haven't talked about it yet, but after I retired from the government, I went to work at the Bellagio. So I left Denver for a few years, and we came back because we wanted to be back with family. But you need to learn solvent systems. Many of the buildings are now built with solar systems, with solvent, because it's cheaper. You run one line up, and you have you come off those ends, and you don't have another line of vents. So it's just another way for the gases to escape through this solvent aerator type of system. So you need to learn that. And then, as I say, this is the book that I have on Amazon.com. This is the book that I'm promoting. This is the book I'm trying to sell. Because once you become a plumber, and once you become a master plumber, and you want to get into commercial maintenance work, which you may or may not want to do. You might want to build new buildings the rest of your 30, 40-year career. And that's fine. I love new work. But there's a point, where you get older and you want to not have to physically carry these pipes as much as you have to. And this is a good line of work to get in, And here, this will teach you about how you control the work and not let the work control you, as we are talking about valves and fixtures and all these different things. This book here will describe and help you with setting up a preventive maintenance program. You'll have a very efficient program if you can follow this. And if you have a building as big as, like, say, the Bellagio and other buildings, if you don't have a good system in place, boy, you're going to be chasing that work. You're going to be overtime. And you might like the overtime. I get tired of it. But you'll be chasing that work and chasing that work and chasing that work because you didn't set up a good preventive program. Just like the VA that I worked 25 years. You try to catch up. You're always trying to catch up, But if you get these programs going, you will catch up. If you do it right and you get the backing from management, get the support and the money. So hang in there and thank you for listening. And I'll have more videos to come trying to teach you how to be a plumber, how to be a good plumber, and how to make a good living. But you gotta like the work too. And I like plumbing. So we'll talk to you later. Bye.